Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Surfer SEO to audit your old and previously published blog posts to improve their chances of ranking on the first page of Google. If you're new to my channel, my name is Corey Alexander. I'm a writer and content creator, and it's my mission to share with you everything I know about how to make money online with your writing. So if you want to stay in the loop on all my latest writing tips, be sure to hit the subscribe button below. Full disclosure, I am an affiliate for Surfer SEO, which is the tool we're talking about in today's video. There are affiliate links in the description box below, which means that if you make a purchase after clicking on one of those links, I may earn a commission at no extra cost to you. So a couple weeks back, I showed you how to use Surfer SEO to optimize your new content. But what do you do about old blog posts that aren't ranking very well? I know how frustrating it is to put in so much time and effort into a piece of content only for it to rank on page 2 or 3 of Google, which is basically the same as it not ranking at all. If you have blog posts like that, then they are the perfect candidate for the Surfer SEO audit tool. This tool shows you exactly what you need to do to optimize your content and give it that little extra nudge it needs to get it on the first page of Google. Now you can use this feature for any of your blog posts, but it does work best for posts that are ranking between 12 and 20 on the Google SERPs. So today I'm going to be walking you through how to use this function using a live example from my own website. Okay, so for today, I'm going to be auditing an old blog post from my blog called thefitcareers.com. This post is almost a year old, so it's definitely due for a refresh. And as you can see, when I search for the keyword phrase, which is how to lose weight without cardio, I am nowhere to be found on page 1. And if we click over to page 2, and here, if we scroll down, you can see here I am near the bottom. So this is the ideal candidate for the Surfer audit function because this article is partially optimized and recognized by Google already. But if we can improve this piece of content, there's a really good chance we can bump it up to page 1. So what I'm going to do is take the URL of that blog post and hop over to my Surfer SEO dashboard and navigate to the sidebar here where it says audit. And from there, I'm just going to paste my URL into the bar here. And underneath, I'm going to type in the keyword I'm targeting, which is how to lose weight without cardio. Underneath that, you can see you can change the country. I always leave this as the US. And I think actually for most people living in North America, you'll want to leave this set as the US because that's where the majority of your traffic is likely coming from. Then you'll see this other tab here where you can crawl for mobile or desktop. I recommend you choose the mobile crawler type to get the most relevant data because of Google's mobile first indexing. And what this means is that Google is mostly using the mobile version of your blog post when ranking content. This is because more than half of the global web traffic is through people's phones. But if you want to double check that you're making the right selections here for your website, just head over to your Google Analytics and go to Audience and Overview. There you'll see a breakdown of where your users are coming from. And for myself, I can see that over 60% of my traffic in the last 3 months has been from the US. And if you want to double check what kind of devices people are using to view your website, you can just scroll down a little further and you'll see a section called Mobile and Overview. And this is where you'll see where your traffic is coming from. So for me, I have like a whopping 75% of my traffic that's coming from mobile. So I definitely want to stick with the mobile crawler type on Surfer. Lastly, you'll see a little switch down here that's called Sentiment. So this is interesting and I looked into it and it basically runs the same audit, but bases it more on what's called true density. So the way I understand it is that this metric determines the keyword's density based on sentiment and context. So I think the idea behind this is that if you use the keyword phrases and capture the right sentiment and context, you don't need to use that phrase as many times as it would recommend you do with the NLP only version. So when you've filled in all your information here, you just click this Create Audit button. So as an experiment, I created 2 separate audits, one with the NLP with sentiment and one with only NLP entities. And just looking at it side by side, you can see my content score is higher with the sentiment page than when it's toggled off. And I think that's because the content gap isn't as high because it's not asking me to put in the keyword phrases as many times. So Surfer's own blog says that true density is the easiest way to optimize your content. So for this demonstration, I'm going to be sticking with the sentiment version to optimize my blog post. So here I'll go through this report top to bottom so you can understand what everything is and what to look for. At the top of the page here, you'll see a button called Select Competitors, and we're just going to click on that to review what competitors the auditor is using to stack our content against. The websites that the Surfer AI chooses is generally pretty good, but you may just want to make a few changes if you notice sites that aren't really your competition. So for example, if you run an informational blog with a lot of affiliate links, then e-commerce sites or product pages are not going to be your competition. And also sites that are super high in domain authority that publish about everything and anything, like say Forbes or Wikipedia, those are also not going to be your competition. So you can toggle those off if you see any sites like that on this list. All right, so under that we have the content score. Mine is already showing a 77, which is pretty good, but that doesn't mean that there isn't room for improvement. If I look at the competition, I can see they are all around the same, even a little bit above me. So I think we can improve this score a bit to beat the competition. The next section is missing common backlinks. And honestly, I don't spend a whole lot of time on this section, but you can check it out and see where your competitors are getting backlinks. So later on, I could look into getting backlinks from some of these websites, but right now I'm looking for easy changes that are going to give me quick wins. Next up, we have the internal links. This section gives you an idea of what kind of internal linking you can do on your own site to improve your content's ranking. And sure enough, when I expand this, there are a number of relevant blog posts within my website that I could link back to this post. So I'm not going to do all of these, but I will definitely take the ones that I think are most relevant and make sure that they're linking somewhere to my blog post. The next section is terms to use. This is probably the most important section of the report. So here we're going to find all the terms and phrases we should add or remove from our piece to optimize our content. So we have all our terms listed on the left side, and then we have some columns here. This first column shows how many times we used this specific phrase in our content, and then next to it is the suggested number of times that we should use this phrase. So for this first one, which is strength training, it shows that I've used it 2 times in the piece, but to optimize it for SEO, I should use it at least 7 times. So over here in the action column, it shows me that I could add this phrase 5 to 32 more times. There's also a sentiment column here, which we have because we toggled on that sentiment function. And this gives us an idea of the context we should be using this phrase in. So for example, if we're using words like awesome, great, or wonderful in conjunction with this keyword, Google will likely see that as a positive sentiment. If we're using words like awful, hate, and negative words like that, Google might see it more as a negative sentiment. We even have examples from our competitors here if we need help figuring out the context in which these phrases are being used. We just click on the examples arrow to see the examples. If we keep scrolling down the report, we find the word count. So here I can see my word count is pretty much on point. I could add some content. It has the range here up to 55, almost 5,600 words. So I probably could add some extra word count here, but it's not really required according to this audit. Next line is basically telling me that I need to add more subheadings, which is another reason why I should probably include another 400 to 500 words in my post. My paragraphs are the recommended length. Next on the report is exact keywords. So this is the number of times I've included the exact keyword phrase throughout my post. And according to this report, I've got it in there just the right number of times, so there's not really too much to change here. Next up is partial keywords. So according to Surfer, these are any words that contain the same first 3 letters that come from the primary keyword phrase. And it looks like I have the right number of partial keywords in my post already. A little further down, we see the page structure. So I have an H1 element. Everything looks good there. Looks like I could add more H2 and H6 subheadings. I have a healthy number of paragraphs. Looks like I could add a few more images. I have 3 images in the post and it's recommending I add between 5 and 11. Further down here, we have the SEO title and meta description. So these 2 items can be easily changed in WordPress, and with the free Yoast SEO plugin, I pretty much always have this optimized. And then these last 2 items here are speed metrics. So you want to make sure that your blog post is loading quickly, because a slow loading page is a page that your visitors will bounce from immediately. And a bad user experience is also going to hurt your rankings. All right, so I know that was a ton of information, but what I'm going to do with this report today is just go for the quick wins, which I'm mostly going to get from this terms to use section. And to do that, I'm just going to sort this by action so that the red and yellow ones are on top. So this is showing the phrases that are either nowhere in my piece at all or aren't added into my article enough times. So here in my WordPress editor, I'm going to edit my piece and I'm just going to write a little bit more content and add some of these keyword phrases without keyword stuffing. So I can probably add a few sections. Like for example, I saw a term about activity thermogenesis, which is something I didn't cover in this blog post previously. So I'm just going to add a few of these phrases because sometimes small changes are all you need to do. And I just want to see how this first round of updates affects my rankings. But I'm not going to bore you with this process of me going through all this because it's going to take me a little bit of time, but I'll bring you back once I finish updating the piece so you can see what comes next. All right, welcome back. So I've updated my article to include more of those terms to use from the report. And I did a couple other things that were easy, like adding an image. And I also added some internal links from several of the suggested pages from the report. So now we wait. According to Surfer SEO, it can take Google a couple of weeks to recrawl and index the site and figure out its new place in the rankings. So it might bounce around for a little bit, but we should see it settle after a couple of weeks. So I'll check back on this piece in 2 weeks to see if it's improved and moved up the rankings at all. So after 2 weeks, if it's moved up a little bit, but it's still not on page one or on the bottom of page one even, I'll come back to this report and I will hit the refresh button. So this will rerun the audit and update all the information to show how the revised content is now performing. And there you have it. We finished an audit using Surfer SEO. So that was a ton of information. And if you found that a little bit overwhelming, have no fear. You can make a lot of progress simply by adding those terms to use from your report. And you can always learn more about the other metrics later. And like I said earlier, there's no reason to try and update everything at once. And in most cases, you're better off to update your article in increments so you can see how it affects your Google rankings. And if you'd like to give Surfer SEO a try, you can find my referral link in the description box. And that's all I have for you today. If you have any questions about the Surfer SEO audit function, please let me know in the comments and I will be around to answer. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.